All right, so I'm going to look at a bunch of music and I'm going to try to quickly transcribe it from one time singer to another as practice. We'll start with some simple time songs in simple time and then move to compound time. All right, the first one I'm going to look at is this choral piece where it's in, we'll see what we can figure out what the time signature is for this piece, okay? Notice, anybody know what that is? That's a breve rest. So it's a breve rest. So a breve is a double whole note, otherwise known as a double whole note. Do we have any breve notes in here anyplace? Anybody see anything here? But I can see that there's a whole rest. No, that's a half rest, sorry. And then a whole note, and then a half. There's a half, and a whole. So that's four half notes right there. One, two, and then there's two in there. There's a whole note, and then that is four quarter notes. So this would be probably in 4/2 time is the time signature for this piece of music. All right. So let's just pick, I'm just going to pick a line, and then we'll count it, and then I will rewrite it in different time signature, right? So let's look, let's say this right here, this line right here, okay? All right, well, there's a whole rest hanging down from that line. So if we're in 4/2 time, remember there's four beats of the measure, it's quadruple meter, and the half note gets the beat in 4/2 time. The half note is what's getting the count. All right. So I have here, there's four half notes right there. Or two whole notes or four half notes right there. The whole measure is a rest. And then we have a whole rest. So that would be beats one and beat two. Right. And then here's a whole note. So that would be beats three and four. So four in parentheses because it's being held. There's that tie. Remember the tie, okay? And then it's still being held over here, and there's beat one. And then this is beat two, two and, because the time signature is 4/2 time. And now here it's three, beat three, and then, but it's three quarter notes long, a dotted half note. So that's three, and then four is right in here someplace, and that would be and. And then this would be one, two in parentheses, and there's three in parentheses because that's a half rest. And then this would be four tied over, so this would be one in parentheses, two, and then three and four in parentheses over here. All right, now let's rewrite this in a different, another time signature. We're in simple time where the beat is evenly divided into two parts, divided into two. So I'm going to rewrite this in, what's a good time signature? I'll put this in bass clef because I know it's in bass clef. Good time signature to so it'll be nice and tricky, So let's try it in the key of 4/8, the time signature 4/8 time. Let's do 4/8 time. Now, when you're thinking about rhythms and when you're doing these transcriptions, do this first. Figure out what the syllables are, all right? Because a lot of times people will try to do this thing where they go, okay, well, it's in 4/2 time, and they're going to do it down, and it works if you're going to just do it in 4/4 time. And they're going to go, well, it's, okay, instead of a half note, it's going to be, if I was doing this in 4/4 time, okay, well, that's actually a quarter note, a quarter rest, or no, quarter rest, and then it'd be two quarter rests. So half rest, that's a whole rest. And they'll just kind of cut it in half. But that doesn't work very well when you're going smaller or larger than just one step. So if we're going to do it in 4/8 time, you want to get used to counting it first. One, oh, that's two in parentheses there too. Hey, why didn't you say something? I was doing it wrong. One, two in parentheses, three. So one, and that's also in parentheses. Oh my goodness. I should be focusing rather than talking. All right. So you got 1, 2, 3, 2, and 3, and 1, 4, 2, 3. All right. So I have my rhythm down. So now, instead of a whole rest for two beats, I got to have two beats of rest down here in 4/8 time. So what would be two beats of rest in 4/8 time, where the eighth note gets the beat? Well, it would be a quarter rest. Quarter rest, that's 2/8 notes, so that's silence for two beats. And then I have this is two beats, and it has a tie to it. So what is two beats, a note that's two beats long in 4/8 time? Well, it would also be a quarter note, because that's 2/8 notes, right? Which is two beats in this time signature. Right? And then it ties over to this. Now that's just one beat in 4/2 time. In 4/2 time, this is one beat. So what's one beat in 4/8 time? Be an eighth note. That's the beat. 4/8 time, that's the beat. So it still sounds the same. 1, 3, 2, and. So what is 2 and in this time signature? All right. Well, since we're putting beams, I'm going to, because it wouldn't be eighth notes, so it'd be 16th notes, because the eighth note gets the beat. So there's 2 and right there. That's 1 parentheses. So 1, 2 in parentheses, 3 and 4 in parentheses, 1, 2, and. Then this, 3 and then it's going to be a dotted note. What kind of dotted note would be the beat? There's the beat, 4, 2, 10, and then half more. All right, so the beat in 4/8 time is a eighth note. So it would be a dotted eighth note. And then that would be the and. What's in 4/8 time, what would the and be? It would be a 16th note. Now, since I'm in 4/8 time, I can do one of two things. The most common would be to take these flags off and make, that's a dotted eighth note. So that's a dotted eighth note, and that's a 16th. Now notice carefully, the beam is on the left-hand side of the note going down, up on the right, down on the left. I'm beaming this, and so I'm going to beam these together. And actually what I would do is, because this note goes down, and this note would go down if it was connected to that. So everybody's going down. Eighth note, 2/16 notes. And we'll talk about which way the stem goes later. We'll give more detail on that. But the reason I did that is because this goes down. This goes with whoever's the most, who dominates. And the top notes usually always dominate. And this guy just kind of goes with him because he's tied, he's connected. So this guy would go down. This guy goes down, so they've all gone down. But don't worry about that right now. I'm not that concerned about that right now. All right, so this is still 1, 2, and 3, 4 in parentheses, and. Now, in the earlier video, I talked about how when you have four beats to the measure in 4/8 time or 4/4 time or even 4/16 time, in quadruple meter, you can beam beats 1 and 2 together and then beam beats 3 and 4 together. You'll see that. And you'll see examples in 4/8 time, sometimes where the whole measure is beamed together. But this is more common because it's 4/4 time. It's quadruple time, four beats of the measure. So the first two beats can be beamed together and then the next two beats. And that's very common in 4/4 time. And in 4/8 time, you'll see it as well. All right, so then we go over here and we got it's two beats long. So what's two beats long in 4/8 time? It's a quarter note. That is one beat, it's a half. So one beat, so what would one beat? One beat, it would be an eighth rest, right? So that's two beats, that's a beat, and then this note here would be an eighth note. And it has a tie over. That's as far as I'll go. There's beats one and two. There's beat three in parentheses, because there's nothing happening, and there's beat four. All right. Let's try another one. All right, here's one. That's what I was telling you about. This is in 4-4 time. And that's really the only thing it can be. I mean, right there you have four eighth notes, and there's another four eighth notes. And remember, in simple time, you're never going to have the top numbers are always going to be 2, 3, or 4. So you couldn't say, oh, that's 8-8 time. There's no such thing. Well, I mean, there is such a thing. There could be such a thing. But that's not, simple time is 2, 3, or 4. All right? 2, 3, or 4. Well, what is 8-8 time? It would be 4-4 time. All right, 4-4 time. You always want to go with the most obvious and common answer. You can see right here, 4 quarter notes, 4 eighth notes, 4 eighth notes, 4 eighth notes, 4 eighth notes. That's very common up here. Look at this. 1 and 2 and 1, 3 and 4 and. That's a little grace note in piano and in instrumental music. You'll see a lot. It's not really counted. It's just played right before the note. Dia da 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 dia dia da dia da. Oh, actually, it's got dotted eighth, 16th. But this is in 4-4 time. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to count the bottom line here. So that'd be 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 2 3 4. 1 and 2 and 3. Okay, pretty simple. Interesting here because they're in a treble clef here, da, 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 and then they jump all the way down to the bass clef to play these notes, and they're in bass clef all the way through here. That's actually bass clef. So that's actually a C sharp and a G, C natural, A, F sharp. That happens. And that's why these aren't beamed together, because it interrupted that, saying, hey, we're going to move all the notes down to way lower than that. That's a B flat. What octave register is that right note right there? Well, that is a B flat 5. It's a B flat 5. The next note up, a C, is a B flat 6. There's C right there. That's B flat. That's C6. That's B5, A5, G5. 1 and 2. Now, I just want to just draw attention to the fact that their first two beats are beamed. These next two beats are beamed. This is super common. All right. I think that's. I just wanted to show you that example of beats 1 and 2, beats 3 and 4. All right. Here is Fjörlis, one of the most famous songs in 3-8 time. And notice the whole measure is beamed together. Whole measure is beamed together. Now, the whole measure is not beamed together here because they're so far apart. You know, being treble and bass clef. But you look at this right off the bat, and you might think that's compound time. Look, da 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 dee, da da. But then I go here and I say, oh, there's a 16th rest and a six. So that's really 1 and 2 and 3. We're in 3-8 time here. So the eighth note gets the beat. There's the beat right there. Beat. All right. So this is a little interesting. You know, it kind of split up like that. But it's still, if you look up here, the top note here, the top line, there's a beat. And then there's a beat. And then there's a beat. Beat. A beat. And another beat. Mm-hmm. Now, he could have, and honestly, if we were writing this today, I would have written this as 2/16 and then a eighth note with a staccato marking above it, you know, a staccato marking like this, which says play it short, like half the distance, half the time. But this is more precise. 1 and 2, One and two and three and one and two and three and one and two and three and one and three and one and two and three and one and two and one. So, this is the three time where the eighth note gets the beat. Look down here, we can see it even more clearly. The whole measure is being together. Remember, what you're in triple time, 3/8 time, even 3/4 time, 3/16 time. The whole measure can be beamed together. Now here they're making a distinction. The melody, that's a quarter note. That's 2/8 notes. So that's 1/2 in parentheses, and there's your third beat right there. And we haven't actually covered the further divisions of the beat in simple time with 16th notes, like 1e and a. We haven't covered that yet, but we will. But here we'd have 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3. Down here you can see there's an eighth note, there's an eighth note, there's an eighth note. Once again, they're not beaming together because these are actually in the treble clef. These are treble clef notes. So while the right hand is playing up here, the left hand is playing, that's middle C, that's C4. Da, 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 da. And then it goes down lower because it reverts back to bass clef here. It's a very common thing we do. These notes are actually, C and E are actually right up here. If you wrote them in bass clef, they'd be right there. Those notes, that's what they look like in bass clef. But they just change the clef sign right here. There's bass clef for just two beats. Treble clef, and then bass clef, and then treble clef, and then bass clef. Yeah, that's a lot. All right, now let's rewrite this. Let's rewrite this in another time signature. All right. So, let's see. We'll go up here. We'll go up here and do this. I'm just going to do the top line here. And we're going to put it in, let's put it in 3/2 time. Okay? 3/2 time. Treble clef, 3/2 time. And we have, what are these called? It's an incomplete measure. So what is that called? Those are called pickup notes. Or an anacrusis. That's terrible. On a cruise. Or upbeats. Alright. It's an incomplete measure. And since the eighth note's getting the beat, how would I count that? How would I count that, those two notes? Well, it would be 3 and. That's a beat. Those two notes land on take up one beat. Because the eighth note gets the beat. So those 2/16th notes, that's 3 and. So this will be 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 3 and 1 and that'd be 2 right here. And there's 2 right there, parentheses. And 3 and 1, 2 in parentheses, and 3 and 1 and okay. Count it out. Now I'm gonna rewrite it. I'm going to rewrite it down here. And 3/2 time. So what would, make my little incomplete measure, 3 and, well, in 3/2 time where the half note gets the beat, where the half note gets the beat, so what is 3 and where the half note gets the beat? Well, it would be 2/4 notes. So that would be this. E, D sharp, E, D sharp. These are all quarter notes. Da 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 da. D natural. C. Alright, so these are all quarter notes. Yeah, I wouldn't write this in 3/2 time. But I would definitely rewrite this in 3/4. It has been. I'm not saying I would do it. This song has been rewritten in modern times in 3/4 time. So these are all eighth notes. That's why I didn't do it 3/8 time, and 3/4 time, because you can find it 3/4 time. All right, 3 and, Did you catch that? Did anybody out loud say, Mr. Cutchen, you made those eighth notes. So that's three and one and two and three and da-da. And then A, instead of a, that would be a half note. Okay, that's one beat. And then this would be a quarter rest. And then this would be all quarter notes. And then another beat, that's a whole beat, so it would be a half note. Okay, and so forth and so on. The same rhythm, it would sound exactly the same. It's just something different got the beat. I mean, there's no rhyme or reason, really, necessarily, that why you would use 3-8 instead of 3-4. Like I say, it's just typically because something was, it was popular. It was what people were doing. And it's like, you know, if people are used to something, you don't want to be throwing something at them. If you want your music played, you don't want to be throwing stuff at them that's really bizarre, though guys do that. Because you want people to play your music. You know? But some people do it because they think it's cool and whatever, and that's all right, too. But if you really want people to play your music, you need to write music that people will want to play. Yeah, typically. But then some people are writing music for different reasons. But. All right, let's do Dance of the Sugar Plum Fairies. This is in 2-4 time. This is pretty famous Tchaikovsky from the Nutcracker Suite. Alright, that's the Dance of the Sugar Plum Fairies Daniel version. All right, so if I'm counting this, I'm just going to count the top line. It's going to be one in parentheses and two in parentheses and one in parentheses and, right? This is one, two. Now, I don't put parentheses on the only beat notes. Only the beat numbers do you put parentheses around if it's a rest or whatever. You don't have to put parentheses around. You don't go one, two, and parentheses. No, don't do that. All right. Now let's look up here. Interesting. Notice that the left hand and the bass clef, the whole measure's beam together, but not up here in the right hand. Now they could have done that, but I think he wanted to draw a distinction between these figures. You notice there's a pattern here. These da 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 da. It's just a little pattern. But these, they have a similar function. You know, they have a very similar function. But like I said, this and that are very different from each other, and I'm sure that's why they did that. But let's rewrite this, and we're going to rewrite this. We'll write the top line, rewrite the type line. And let's put it where this is in 2-4 time. What do you want to do? Let's put it in, I might as well put it in 2-8 time. That would be something you would see. All right, so let's do it in 2-8 time. So I count on this one, and I guess I shouldn't have done this, but anyway, and in when the 16th notes are, when the quarter notes being split up into farther than 2/8 notes. So here's a quarter note, there's the 8th notes, 16th notes are like this. I didn't leave enough room. So you got one, one, and one E, and that's how we count the divisions of the beat like that. One E and a, two E and a, two E and a. And I know I've gone over this a little bit, but so that's one, that eighth note is beat one, half of it, and there's and, but it's got two notes being played on that second half of the beat, so that's and a. And that would be two and. See, that and happens right in the same place this would happen, except there's two notes. So you have to, that's why we call it and that's why we call it two E. E would be right in here someplace. So this was one and, look at this, here it is. Two E and. Two E. Because that's two notes being played right in the space of this one, this eighth note. Two, there's and. So 2E and. 1 and, 2E and. 1 E and. 2 E and. 1 E and a 2. Da 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 da. Ba da da da. Okay. So let me rewrite this in 2/8 time. So this first rest, if the eighth note is getting the beat now. Now think about it. The eighth note's getting the beat instead of the quarter note. So what would that rest look like down here in 2/8 time? It would be half. No, it would be half. It'd be half of a beat. So what's half of a beat in 2/8 time? It would be a 16th note. A 16th rest, excuse me. So now these notes, I'm not going to put all of them, I'll just put the bottom one. All right, so now, those 16th notes, well, what would anda? This is now the second half of this beat. So instead of 16th notes, it would be 32nd notes. All right, because there's eighth note, here's the beat right here. A 16th rest, and then 2/32nd notes. That's equal to one of these. That's equal to an eighth. And then this, instead of eighth notes, instead of eighths, because you got eighth note, so this would be 16ths. So that's still one in parentheses and a two and. Now, technically, I mean, if I wanted to for some reason, I could have connected all those together. I could have connected all those together. But you're always safe when you beam on the beat. There's one beat, there's another beat. Then this would be, da, da, da. I'll just choose this note, da, da, da. All right, so well, that's 1 and 2 E and. So what is 1 and with eighth note? It's 16th notes. And this will be D, D, D. So now I've got, all right, this is a 16th note. That would be a 16th note, but it's not. It's two notes, so I have to. So I'm going to put this here for this, and then one more. There's 32nd. So that's 1 and 2 E, and the eighth note gets the beat. So there's a eighth note, and there's an eighth note. So that's the beat right here. 2 E and 1 E and 2 E. All right. Let's go into compound time. First I want to look at, there was one more simple thing I wanted to do. I want to point this out. Fur-lease, we showed a Fur-lease. Who's texting me? Wow, lots of texts. Now, you remember how we started with the pickup notes here? Three and. I want to show you the end of this song, the end of this piece. Here's the very end. And this is what happens. That's one and two and three and one. There's two in parentheses. And where's beat three? At the very beginning, there's three and. So that's very common. All right. Now I'm going to look at. Uh, Let's look at this piece by Mendelssohn. It's a 9/8 time. So remember, we have duple, triple, and quadruple, right? Duple, triple, quadruple. And we're in compound time. And these are pickup notes. This is an anacrusis. These are pickup notes. Now remember how we count compound time? We count it one lolly, or depending on what's getting the beat, one lolly. That's how we count. Each beat has three pulses, has three parts of the beat. All right. So in this time, you know, if this was the beat, then if these three notes were a beat, that's what a beat looks like in compound. Remember, in compound time, all the beats have dots behind them. All the beats have dots behind them. And so here's one beat. That's the division of the beat. That's the divided beat figures. Divided beat figures. In compound time, that's the divided beat figure. And then here is a beat. Now, so in this, if this was the three parts, the beat would be a dotted quarter note. If this was the beat right here, the beat note would be, well, two sixteenths equals an eighth, and then one more sixteenth would make it a dot. That's the beat. This would be 6/16 time. This would be, or 9/16 or 12/16, depending on how many beats in the measure. This would be 6/8 time, or 9/8 time, or 12/8 time, depending on your duple, triple, or quadruple meter. But there would be, that'd be a beat, and that's what it would look like if you just wanted to play one note. If it was just da, 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 we'll see it in a minute. All right, so we're in 9/8 time. We got pickup. So this is beat, we're in triple time, right? So this is beat three. Three, la, li. That's three, la, li. Three, la, li. One, two, li. Three, la, li. One, two. Li, three, la, li. One, la, li. Two, three, li. All right? So this is, pick on this. This would be li. And this would be three, la, li. Because this is the last beat of this, you know, well, at the end of the song. At the end of the song, we'd find the rest of this. But for now, just trust me. At the end of the song. But this is, so this is not a beat. This is just the tail end of beat two. There's two other eighth notes in front of this, and they're all beat two. But that's just the very last part of the beat of the three. Like this right here. That's this right here. And then it goes into beat three, three lolly. And this is beat one, and here's beat two, but not all of it. There's the rest of it. Beat two. So la is in here someplace, but it's not being played because it's a quarter note. It's got two eighth notes. But here's the last eighth note of the beat, and so that would be li. And this would be three la li, and this would be one, two, li, three la li, right, so forth and so on. This would be one la li, two. It's a dotted quarter note, so that's two, all of beat two, and then this is beat three li. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna keep going. There's beat one. There's all beat one. That's one. Here's beat two, but it's not all of it. It's just, and because they're starting a new section, Mendelssohn or whoever scored this. But that is beat two, but it's not all of it. Here's the rest of it. Here's li. One, two, li. It's starting a new section. That's why. Starting a whole new section. So they put the double bar lines here. So this would be beat three, and that would be li. And there's one, two in parentheses. That's two in parentheses. Li, three, li, one, two in parentheses. Li, three, li. Okay. Now look at this. That's, I'm not going to count that, but one, One, Lee, two, Lee, and there's a little pickup note, we're not counting that. And that's three, Lolly. Mm-hmm. Now, if I was going to transcribe this into another time signature, all right, so let's, instead of 9-8, that's what I wrote. Instead of 9, let's put it in, 9-4 time, which is a very common time signature in compound time. Mm-hmm. And let's go ahead and put it this, and, treble clef, terrible treble clef. That's my treble clef. All right, and I'm not going to do all those notes, I'll just put this one right here. So we got that three, la, li. Let's go up here. All right, so what is Lee, three, la, li, look like in 9-4 time? So 9-4 time, here's the beat in 9-4 time. That's the beat. So there's three beats the measure, and it's this triple time, and each beat is this. That's the beat. One, so this is three beats in 9-4 time. One, la, li, two, la, li, three, la, one, two, three. But the division of the beat looks like that. All right. So, if this is, that's one lolly, two lolly, okay? There's one, two, one lolly, two lolly, three lolly, all right? So this is, Lee is going to be a quarter note now. And then three lolly, they're all quarter notes. Now, remember what I said in the last video about this? When the note's low or high, that the stem, if it goes up an octave, it's going to fall short of this, then you just bring it all the way up to that middle line. Octave long, an octave from this would go right here, but it has to go at least up to that line. All right, so then you'd have this note, and it would be, instead of a dotted quarter note, it's going to be what? Going to be a dotted half note. All right, so there's da, and then I'll just keep that here for this note. Now it's a quarter note, but in this time signature it would be a half note, and then that would be a quarter note. And I go down the left because it's around the middle line there, and then here, ba, da, da. Alright, and these would be, three lolly would be all quarter notes. And so forth and so on. That would be a dotted half note. And down here would be the half note. Right. So compound time, the same principle applies. You still have to count it. Right. So let's do some more counting. Let's pull out this is a more modern one. This is a worship song. Mm-hmm. Are you hurting and broken within? There's a lot of songs now in compound time, which is to me a little crazy because it's really hard to read. I mean, most people can't read it, but you're going to learn to read it because, yes, you could go, this song is a popular song. You go to the internet and you can watch a video and you can learn it. But what if it's a new song? Or what if it's one somebody in your team or you who written the song and you want to notate it? You want to write it out for people. Well, if you don't know how to count this stuff, then you're not going to be able to do it. But as a musician, you really need to know how to do it. That's what we do as musicians. We do this stuff. All right? So, let's just mark out the beats, first of all. Let's just mark out the beats. 6-8 times. So we're in duple meter, it's compound time. Remember, compound time is anything with a 6, 9, or 12 at the top. This is happens to be 6-8, so the beat is going to be what? What is the beat in 6-8 time? Well, it's the combination of 3 eighth notes. So 3 eighth notes would be a dotted quarter note. That's the beat. It's also going to look like this. 1, 2, 3, 1 lolly, 1 lolly, 2 lolly. Right? Now, this is pretty complicated, and I've noticed this. That's why, if I was doing this, if I had started this process, I would not have put it in 6-8 time. I would have put it in, 3-4 time or something. or even 6/4 time would be a lot easier to read. But in counting compound time, we're just going to go over this now. Yes, you can have more notes than just the three. You can further divide it up. Just how you can do it, you can divide up in simple time. How you can make in simple time, there's 2/4 time. That's 1 and 2 and, or you can go 1 E and 2 E and, you know, here's 1, 2, 1 and 2 and, 1 E and 16th note, 2 E and 1 E. So you can do that in simple time, but we're in compound time. So how are we going to count when you have more notes than just three? So you have this. And you can even have this. Da 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 da. Well, we say this. Now there's different ways of doing this. You know, there's always exceptions, and there's people have different ways. But the most common that I've seen, one ta, la ta li. So in compound time, the division, further division of the beat in compound time, if you have you put a ta in between them. One ta la ta li ta. One ta la li ta, two ta la li ta, one ta la li ta. It's hard to say at first, you have to practice. Alright? So in this counting here, let's just go through. First, we're going to count the beats. Just identify the beats first. All right. Well, there's a dotted quarter note there. That's the beat. There's beat one. All of beat one right there. Now here I have eighth, eighth, and then that's 2/16, which is the same as an eighth, right? So there's my second beat right here. And then where's my beat? Well, they're all beamed together. Look how they're beaming on the beat. So that's one la li ta. One la li ta, one la li ta, because there's two notes being played on that, where that eighth note would be, on that, where that eighth note would be. It's got two notes, so you got one la li ta, because that's the beginning of it, so that would be the li, and then there's another one right after it, and that would be ta, because this is two la li ta, ta li. Because this is the beginning of it. That's the beginning of this part of the beat. Tu la lita, and that would be one ta. And that'd be la, and that'd be li, but we're not going to do that. In the same way, we don't put parentheses around, you know, around eighth rest and stuff like that. Just beat notes. Just the numbers is all we put. So that would just be tu la li ta ta di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-da. It's pretty fast. All right. But here is the beat. There's the beat. There's an eighth, and that's two eighth notes. Here's the next beat. That's one in parentheses, la li ta again. Here's another beat. There's another beat. There's another beat. It's repetitive. All right, and there's right here, you got beat two, two la li. That's that one ta, one ta, one ta. That was really fast. One, do you thirst for a drink from the well? Jesus is calling. Now, how do we count this? There's beat one, but it's got that dot, so it goes over the law. Right, the law is in here someplace, and there's li. One, well, that wouldn't be law, because that's going over it. It would just be ta. One ta li, one ta li, one ta li. Got another one. Another 6/8 time. One who, we're gonna do this tomorrow in chapel, in the school I lead worship. So here's one in parentheses, and that would be la, li, ta, and then two is in parentheses because it's got a tie. La, li. Now, I'm not going to do this because this is we'll talk about it later, but that's where you're basically, what you're doing here is, for just this one beat, you're borrowing simple time. You're in simple time for just one beat. So instead of da 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 da, and it would actually be counted one ta. Give this one la ta. Don't stress out over that. All right, so this would be beat two, two la li, and be li, and there's one, two, one, two in parentheses. One in parentheses, la, li, ta, one in parentheses, la, li. Same thing. One, two, three. Look at this. There's one. I said three. One. And here's two in parentheses here. And so this would be what? Would be la, li. One, la. One, two, three. One in parentheses, la, li, one, two. One, two in parentheses, la, li, one, two, one, two in parentheses, la, li, one, two. Now look at this. How would you count this? Da, da. So that would be beat one. So this would be beat two, but it's just the first eighth note in the series, right? So this would be what? It would be la. And then li is in here someplace. And then here we have beat one, but it's tied, so we wouldn't do anything new there. But then here we go, what is that? That's going to be la. One, two, la, la, two, la, la. And then you have two. That's a tie, so it's going to turn to this. One, la, li, two, la, li, one, la, li, two, la. All right, what else? Okay, here's a song in 12/8 time. And what is 12/8 time? Well, it's in quadruple meter. It's four beats of the measure. Four beats of the measure. In 12/8, what gets the beat? What gets the beat in 12/8 time? Or 9/8 time, or 6/8 time. Well, the beat is this. And the subdivision of the beat is this. Okay? So look at this. Look at all those eighth notes beam together. Once again, we see the same principle happens. There's four beats to the measure here. That's four beats to the measure. So they're beaming the first two beats. See, this is one lolly, two lolly, three lolly, four lolly, one lolly, two lolly, three lolly, four lolly, one lolly, two lolly. So they're beaming beats one and two together. This is compound time, but this is still beat one's there, beat two is there, beat three is there, and beat four is there. And you look down here, you can see even more clearly. One, two, three, and then four in parentheses. What is that? That would be li. One, look up here. It's one lolly, two lolly, three lolly, four lolly. One lolly, two lolly, three lolly, four. One in parentheses, one and then two in parentheses, and there's three. And you cut it short a little bit. You don't hold that note all the way through. You just at the very end, and then there's the third beat. One, two, three, li, one, two, three, li, one, two, three, four, one, two, lolly, three, and there's two beats there. Because remember, if this is the beat note, what is two of these? What would one note, you would replace, if you just want one note instead of these two, you want to hold it for two beats, what is two beats in 12/8 time, or 6/8 time, or 9/8 time? What's two beats look like? Well, it's two of these. So how much is two dotted quarter notes? Well, two quarter notes is a half note. And then what's the dots? What does that equal? Well, it equals a quarter. It would it would be eighth and eighth, eighth and eighth. So this would be a dotted chord. That's two beats in 6/8 or 9/8 or 12/8 time, where the eighth note is divided. It's three eighth notes for every beat. So you put these, one note that would equal that or that is going to be a dotted half note. So down here, there's two beats. That's two beats. That's two beats. One, two, three, four. That's two beats. That's one, two in parentheses, three. Oh, what happened? I think there's a mistake here. That's really funny. That's a mistake. That's really funny. This should have this. A quarter note, a dotted quarter rest. Oh, that's really funny. You get stuff off the internet, you never know what you're gonna get. All right, let's see what time signature this is. All right, what do you think? Looking at this, what do you think? What's the time signature? Well, I look at it and go, it's compound time. I mean, I know it's compound time because there's three notes, three batches of three, right? So how would I count this top line? This would be one and two in here someplace, because there's your second beat. One lolly, two lolly, three lolly, four lolly, one. So this would be beat three, and this would be beat four. There's beat one, there's beat two. Got a tie, so that's beat three is in parentheses, but it's not the whole thing. There's the rest of it. There's the lee, and then that's beat four, and then there's lee again. One, two in parentheses, three, four. Okay. Right here, look, you can see that one, two, lolly, three, dot, dot, four, dot, lee. One, two, lolly, three, dot, dot, four, dot, lee. Notice how they match up? Right. So they wanted to play that really short. You wanted that short, you wanted to be sure. That's why he's put on his resting. All right. Now notice here. A dotted whole note. Well, that's four beats in this time signature of dotted quarter note, dotted quarter note, dotted quarter note, dotted quarter note. Well, we know that those, if you did one note, it would be that. There's two beats. So two of those, what is a dotted half note and a dotted half note together? Well, that's half note, and half note would be a whole note, and then that would be a quarter note longer, and that would be a quarter note long. So that's two quarter notes extra, so two quarter notes would be a half note. So that's four beats in this time signature of 12/8. One lolly, two lolly, three lolly, four lolly, one. Something like that. Okay, well, I think we're about done here. I've got plenty of other examples, but I think I've tortured you enough with this stuff. There's another famous song in compound time, Clair de Lune. Da 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 da. There's that one. Look at this. That is borrowed from Simple Time. They wanted that feel. Now, that's the same. That thing right there is exactly the same as what you saw in the other, that worship song. That, these sound exactly the same. Well, I shouldn't say that, I guess. Not exactly. I mean, some people might make a distinction, but essentially they're the same thing. But here, they definitely borrowed this figure. They go, well, we can't make it work. So this is a way of doing it and still being in compound time. But here, they actually said, I'm going to borrow this from Simple Time and just use that, and so they had to put a little bracket here and say two, because it's going to feel like, instead of da 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 da, one lolly, two lolly, three lolly, three lolly. Now notice we have a lot of ties in here, so this is one in parentheses, lolly, two, three in parentheses. And that note right there would be one in parentheses, and that'd be la, li, two, la, li. Three lolly, you know, parentheses, okay. So there's compact. Okay, I am gonna stop now. I'm gonna quit torturing this. But I have one more thing, but anyway, I can do it. All right, I hope that helps a little bit more with understanding time signatures, both in simple time and in compound time. One, two, and a three, and one, and a three, two, and a three, and one. We'll do this later. Okay, bye. Bye, I hope it was good and you had fun. Oh, my fingers. Oh.